Welcome back, my friends, to the show that never ends, the wonderful world of guzzies. Okay, so guzzy problem. One of the major guzzy problems is on these early engines, you've got threaded exhaust ports. Voila. Now, every engine I've ever come across that had threaded exhaust ports, Norton's especially, these are a problem. They either corrode stuck, you can't get them out, the nuts that is, or they vibrate loose and wear the threads out, so you're buggered whichever way you are. But guzzies mostly seem to be corroded in because of using dissimilar metals. So we've got a brass nut, aluminum head, aluminium head, and this baby was stuck in solid, would not move. Tried C-spanners on it, various types, would not shift. Tried the good old oxyacetylene on it, alternatively heating this and alternatively heating that, letting them cool down overnight, heating that, let it cool down, heat this, and then shock it with one of those freeze sprays. Nah, nothing worked. Tried all different kinds of penetrating oils, all different ones, and a couple of others that I've thrown away. Tried the acetone and automatic transmission fluid trick. That didn't work. So what did I do in the end? Well, I'd almost given up on the job and was going to put the heads back on with the exhaust headers still attached when I read of something somewhere about using good old lemon juice and vinegar. So what I did was I cleaned all this off with brake fluid and set fire to it to burn it all out. Gave it a good wire brushing so it was as clean as I could get it into here on the join. And then I applied lemon juice and vinegar with my patented lemon juice applicator and left it for a day. Tried it again, didn't work. Cleaned it all out with brake cleaner, burnt the brake cleaner off, wire brushed it, put more in. Did that 3 times. And on the third day, which is probably 2.5 weeks after I originally started, because I was letting this thing soak with penetrating oil, which was a waste of time. So on the third day, applying heat only to the head around here, getting it as hot as I could. And it takes a while because aluminium, aluminium conducts heat away really fast. You know, everybody thinks that these engines overheat. Well, they don't, because the engines are on cold. Anyway, so I got some heat around here and I started attacking this with a hammer and a blunt instrument, and it finally began to move very, very little like that. So I would tap it that way, tap it back. Tap it that way, tap it back, tap it that way, tap it back. And gradually, it got more. Being very, very careful never to take it more than an eighth of a turn at a time. Plus pouring in the penetrating oil, then going back and giving it a bit more heat and doing this. Took me half an hour to get it out, but eventually it popped out. These threads are fine, absolutely fine. And the threads in here, although they're a bit corroded, I don't know if you can see, they're actually not too bad. So they'll clean up a bit and they won't need any further repair, thank goodness. An expensive repair and then trying to find somebody who can do it. Okay, in the meantime, this wasn't on the bike. I've taken the heads off. And what I did was I made a plate like this to take up where the head bolts would normally go. And there's an old gasket in between here to protect the gasket surface of the head, because I don't want to damage that, obviously. So anyway, once that one was done, I set to work on this one. And because I knew what to do, it came off relatively easy, just a couple of overnight soaks and application of heat, and out she came. This one, admittedly, is not quite so badly corroded. Probably can't see. Not quite so bad. But corroded nonetheless, and there would be a ring of corrosion that would stop me from being able to undo it easily. So anyway, that's how you do it. Lemon juice and vinegar. Your old grandmother's remedy for cleaning cooking ranges and stuff like that. Another thing, when it comes to knocking these off, obviously C-spanner is a waste of time. I'm going to make a C-spanner that encloses the whole thing and grips on all of these lugs, because the regular C-spanner only grips on one and it just rips the corner off if you give it any heave-ho. So if you use a nice big punch like this, well, that's not bad. If you look at the angle that you can hit it at, you're still hitting the edge, right? So I found a better way to do it was to use a good old crescent wrench or adjustable spanner, whatever you like. A nice big heavy one. And what you do is you open it wide up and then you hit it like that. Right, you put it in there and you give it a woofty with a hammer. And you're hitting, not only are you hitting at the right angle, but you're also hitting down the base of the lug, so it's a lot less likely to shear off. And if you look at this, I gave this some fair old hammer. And that's where I started, look. That's the first wallop. And that's what got it going. And I hit it right down here where it's strongest. And then after that, maybe only that one that's got a little bit of damage on it. Oops, lost my focus. I'll take my finger down. Oh, can't see. But anyway, you get the drift. Drift, haha, joke there. So yeah, hit it with one of these. You're not going to hurt it because this is tool steel and this is brass. So this is going to give way long before that. So you're not going to hurt this. So that's the way to do it. Lemon juice, vinegar, and the application of brute force with a blunt instrument. Hope you're having a good day. Look after yourselves. Take care of one another. Have fun with your guzzies. See you next time. Bye-bye.